Good afternoon, children. In our previous class, we read about different types of land revenue systems which were adopted by the Britishers to earn more and more profits. And those systems like Jamindari system, Royatwari system and Mahalwari system, they all were introduced by the Britishers for collection of land revenue. Now today we will see that how these land revenue collection helped the Britishers, and now they started forcing our farmers to grow commercial crops. Commercial crops means those crops which were used as a raw material to feed British industries. Industrial revolution took place in Britain and most of the industries were based on textile. For textile industries, what is the raw material? Cotton. So they forced our farmers to grow cotton to feed their textile industries in Britain. And as a result, what happened? India was the leading producer of cotton, but India became the largest importer of cotton textiles, because all the raw material cotton Britishers took away from India to feed their industries in Britain, and then they flooded our markets with their machine made goods, and those machine made goods were of better quality also, as well as cheaper also. So it ruined Indian handicraft industries. And with strong footholds in South India, Bengal, Bihar and Orissa, the East India Company wanted to collect maximum taxes. Why they wanted to collect maximum taxes? To meet their military and administrative expenses. Why military expenses were increasing? Because they wanted to capture more and more territories. Asian African countries, they set up their colonies in these poor countries, and to meet these expenses, money was needed, and for that they forced our farmers to give more and more revenues. They also wanted to gain maximum profit, so the company started using very oppressive methods to procure goods which were in great demand in Europe. Which goods were great demand in Europe? Cash crops, agricultural raw material, as a raw material for the industries. The agricultural raw material was purchased at very low rates, like cotton they purchased at very low rates, and then they sent this to England. And after that, the finished goods, the machine made goods, were brought back to India and sold at high price to earn more and more profits. The main intention of the Britishers was to earn more and more profits. The company forced the farmers. Here we are talking about which company? British East India Company. East India Company forced the farmers, which farmers? Our Indian farmers, to grow cash crops. Cash crops means commercial crops. Commercial crops means what I told? Those crops which were needed as a raw material in British industries, like indigo. They forced our farmers to grow indigo. Then they forced our farmers to grow cotton. Then opium, it is a type of a drug. Then pepper, then tea, etc. And sugar cane also, they forced our farmers to grow sugar cane, etc. These cash crops to feed British industries, they forced our farmers to grow. Indigo means, you must be knowing, it is called blue. In Hindi, it is called neel, that is used to in white cotton clothes. It is used to make the sign, to bring the sign. And this indigo was in great demand in the textile industries of Britain. I have told you industrial revolution took place in Britain and most of the industries were set up in the field of textiles. That's why they forced our farmers to grow cotton. Cotton is the raw material for our textile. Then they compelled them to raise silkworm also. Silkworm, why they compelled our farmers to raise? Because silkworm is a raw material for silk. The Britishers wanted to smuggle and sell opium. Opium is a type of drug. Chinese king prohibited it. But Britishers, they wanted to send and to make Chinese addict of opium. And for that, they forced our farmers to grow opium because they flooded China with their opium. They made the Chinese people addicted of opium. Opium is a type of drug. Then they this in indigo, I was talking about indigo, it is called neel in Hindi, was in great demand in the textile industries of Britain, and the peasants were forced to cultivate indigo plants to extract blue dye. Champaran Satyagraha, Gandhiji's first Champaran Satyagraha was for helping these indigo farmers only, because Britishers were forcing our farmers to grow indigo and our farmers were reluctant to grow indigo because indigo cultivation of indigo plants made the soil infertile and it needed lots of labor also. Then their time also, and farmers were not able to grow other crops, and Britishers were given very less money for this indigo. That's why our farmers refused to grow indigo, and for their help, Gandhiji led his first satyagraha in Champaran district of Bihar. These all the forcing, Britishers forced our farmers by oppressive methods to grow these cash crops, and they led miserable life. Our farmers led miserable life because Britishers were giving very low price for this indigo and other cash crops. Then they also forced our farmers to grow sugar cane. Opium, I told you, opium, they made the Chinese addicted of opium. Then paper tea also, paper was for spices, and the rising demand of sugar in the West attracted many Europeans to set up sugar plantation in India. And the farmers earlier they were producing gur, that is jaggery, from this sugar cane for local requirements, and those farmers were now forced to produce thickened sugar cane juice. Why they forced the farmers to produce thickened sugar cane juice? For the sugar factories, and sell their produce at a very low price. The British industries flourished at the cost of Indian industries. Means Indian industries were exploited. They were ruined by the Britishers, and British industries flourished. Then now we will see what was the condition of the farmers. We have to see condition of the farmers. Because of all these atrocities committed by the Britishers, the conditions of the farmers was not good. They were already suffering from natural calamities like flood, drought and famine. And these Indian farmers were further overburdened with high taxes, then repayment of loans, then debts and high rate of interest. They were leading a life of misery, poverty and frustration. As a result, what happened? Many peasants who failed to pay the land revenue lost their land and became landless laborers. They were forced to work at very low wages, so their conditions deteriorated only. Now What happened when they led a miserable life? Whenever atrocities, repression and exploitation reached beyond a certain limit, there was a mass outburst in the form of revolt or rebellion. Whenever it is very well said, excess of anything is bad. And that's why it is whenever atrocities, repression and exploitation reached beyond a certain limit, there was a mass outburst in the form of revolt or rebellion. There was a long list of injustices meted out to the farmers at various times during the British rule, like land revenue settlements and their administration. Whatever the land revenue settlements, in my previous class I have told you, that was miserable for the farmers. And then economic exploitation. The Britishers exploited the farmer economically. They had to pay huge taxes when there was no crops then also. Economic exploitation, especially of the rural masses, the people living in the village area. Then long standing loans and indebtedness, it was also a reason of farmers' poor condition. Then eviction of peasants from land led them to become landless laborers. Eviction of peasants from their land. Why it was? Because they were unable to pay the taxes. When there was no crops, because of any type of natural calamities, then also they had to pay huge taxes to the Britishers. And when they were unable to pay the taxes, then peasants were evicted from their land. And as a result, what happened? They became landless laborers. These causes resulted in revolts, outbreaks and rebellions even before the First War of Independence. First War of Independence was fought in which year? 1857. First War of Independence. In which year? 1857. In 1857 it was a major outbreak. But before that also various small revolts were started by the peasants. Like it was only in 1930. In 1930 that the organization of Kisan Sabha started supporting the cause of peasants. They were revolting earlier, and in 1930 organization of Kisan Sabha started supporting the cause of the peasants. The riots of Bengal, the cultivators of Bengal refused to grow indigo, and rebellion broke out in 1859. That was known as Blue Rebel. Then Moflas of South India revolted against the increasing burden of taxation in 1860s and 1870s. Then the Deccan riots turned violent in 1875 due to rural indebtedness. It was all after First War of Independence of 1857. The peasant movements of Champaran in Northwest Bihar started in 1860 and went on till 1920s. The peasants opposed cultivation of indigo and high taxes. As I have told you, Gandhiji helped and led his first satyagraha at Champaran only. Then Pratapgarh, Rai Bareli, Sultanpur and Faizabad in Uttar Pradesh witnessed opposition by the farmers against high revenue. The Audh Kishan Sabha was formed under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru in 1920. Then increase in revenue was opposed by farmers of Tanjore in which year? In 1923 and 24. The first Rights Association was organized by N.G. Ranga in which year? 1923. Then the Kisan movement in Uttar Pradesh demanded the abolition of Jamindari system. In 1927 at Bardoli, Sardar Patel opposed the increase in revenue by the Bombay Presidency Satyagraha forced the government to revise the revenue. And the peasants of Khera, that is also Khera Satyagraha, opposed the revenue rise. So we have seen the farmers revolted at various places, and these were the causes why the farmers revolted, because land revenue settlements were very high, because they were exploited by the Britishers, because their indebtedness was increasing, and because they were evicted from their land and they became landless farmers. Now we will read about colonialism and tribal societies. Earlier we have seen that how colonial rulers, how the Britishers exploited our farmers. Now we will see how they exploited the tribal groups also. The profitable exploitation means whatever the exploitation they did on the farmers, ultimately they gained profit only. So the profitable exploitation of peasants made the British greedier. They became more selfish, and their next target was the tribal societies, tribals of India, who lived in deep forests and led a life of self-sufficiency. Whatever they were needed, they were getting from the forest. They did not ask anything from anyone. Their traditional economy was built around forest, and they firmly believed that the forest belonged to them and they belonged to the forest. But because of various reasons, Britishers started encroaching in their forest. Most tribals like Khonds of Orissa, in one mark questions, they always ask, the questions are always asked about the tribal groups. Like Khonds were from which state of India? You can write Khonds from Orissa. Khonds of Orissa practice sifting cultivation. Sifting cultivation means the tribals were clearing the forests. They were growing crops for 2 to 3 years, and then they went another field, another piece of land. There they cleared the forest and then they started their doing cultivation. Means they were not doing cultivation at one place. That was sifting cultivation. Many tribal groups like Van Gujars of Himalayas. Van Gujars. Gujars of Himalayas. Himalayas means J&K, Jammu and Kashmir. Then Gaddis of Kullu. These were the tribals. Gaddis of Kullu. Kullu means Himachal Pradesh. They lived by herding and rearing of animals. Amongst the Mundas of Chota Nagpur. Mundas were from which part? This Munda community, tribal communities. Mundas of Chota Nagpur. Mundas of Chota Nagpur. According to them, the land belonged to the clan, means one caste as a whole, and all members had equal rights on the land. But when the Britishers started entering into the forest, why did they enter into the forest? For timber. Timber was the best quality of wood. And that time railways were started and railway tracks were made from timber wood. Then water transport was also very developed that time. And for water transport, for making ships, timber wood was needed. So now we will see what were the impact on the tribal life after Britishers, this policy of exploitation, what was the impact on the tribal life? Almost every tribe had a tribal chief. Tribal chief means head of the community. But under the British rule, the chiefs lost power and they were forced to follow the laws made by the British officers in India. Means tribal chief, they lost their powers. But the Britishers did not want sifting cultivation. Why Britishers did not want sifting cultivation? Because it was very difficult for them to collect the taxes and to control the movement of tribals. but the tribals wanted to continue shifting cultivation. The changes made in the forest laws by the British made the tribal life very difficult because they were not free to take anything from the forest. Most of the forest were declared as the state property, means property of the Britishers government, and that time Britishers were ruling upon us, so they were declared as state property, especially the reserved forest. Britishers, some forest they categorized the forest, and some forests were named as reserved forest, means they were reserved for whom? They were reserved for the Britishers only, and the tribal groups were not allowed to go to this reserved forest. And these forests were declared as state property, and these reserved forests were famous for its timber. Timber is the best quality of wood. Many tribals had to move to other areas in search of livelihood, because all the livelihood, they were self-sufficient in their forest products only, and when they were forced to leave the forest, then they moved to other areas in search of livelihood. And why they were forced by the Britishers to leave the forest? Because Britishers protected the forest, categorized them as reserved forest for what? For the best quality of wood, and that was for timber. They needed timber wood. This created a shortage of laborers to cut trees for the railway sleepers and to transport logs. I have told you that railway was introduced by the Britishers, and for railway sleepers timber wood was needed, but when the tribals left the forest, then there was a shortage of laborers. During the 19th century, when the demand for the forest produce increased, the traders and the money lenders took advantage of the situations. Traders, those who were doing business from these timber roads, and money lenders, those who were exploiting the situations of the tribals by giving money on high interest. They went to the tribals, traders and money lenders, they took the advantage of the situation. They went to the tribals and offered them cash loans, means loans in cash. They also asked them to work for wages. It led to further misery of tribals. Now we will see the case of Santhals of Hazaribagh. Hazaribagh. That Hazaribagh is in Jharkhand area, and these Santhals were rearing silkworms for the production of cocoons. When the demand for Indian silk increased, efforts were made to encourage silk production, and the traders, their agents and many middlemen approached the growers, those who were growing silk cocoons. They gave them cash loans and collected cocoons from them. And how miserable, children, you can think. You will be surprised to know that they just paid ₹3 for 1,000 cocoons. Cocoons means from where the raw material silk is being extracted. And they gave the farmers only ₹3 for 1,000 cocoons, and then sold them at 5 times more. Profit was going into the hands of whom? To the traders. When the tribal groups, Santhals of Hazaribagh, here we are talking about Santhals of Hazaribagh. When the tribal groups came to know of the reality, means they are taking only ₹3, they are giving only ₹3 for 1,000 cocoons and selling at 5 times higher rate, then they were shocked. Santhals of Hazaribagh were shocked and started considering the traders as their enemy. Many tribals had to leave their forest homes in search of work. A large number of them were recruited through contractors to work in the tea plantation. In tea plantation, they were inducted, they were recruited by the contractors as the laborer in far off areas of Assam. Tea plantation was going on there only. they were paid there also, they were paid low wages and were not allowed to go back home. So the plight of these tribals deteriorated only. The plight of the coal mine workers was also not less than them, tribal groups. Their plight was also miserable. Many tribals were also recruited in factories and fields to work under very harsh conditions. And as I have told you, excess of anything is bad. When the atrocities crosses the limit, then what happens? Revolt. In our next class, we will read about the tribal revolts. Today this much only, and your homework is you have to make the chart. You have to make the chart of page number 114. In it, commercial crops is written, name and places they were cultivated. So make the chart of page number 114 and submit it on your WhatsApp group. That's all for today. Goodbye.